last question. Never think of consequences. I didn't feel a thing. I didn't feel a thing. I never think twice, no intentions. Never feel the consequences. Until it starts to sting. Until it starts to sting.
Hey guys, Legendary Ghidorah here today, and today we have Nergigante versus Fin Fang Foom. So without further ado, let us begin. The Elder Dragon of Balance, Nergigante has cemented himself as a pretty popular character in the Monster Hunter franchise, even leading over to, well, even other Capcom crossovers. Nergigante is incredibly strong, actually able to send Morgan Ainslin flying around with her attacks, being able to overpower other Elder Dragons like... Sorry, my throat. Like Kushala Deora, Teostra, Velkana, and Lunastra. He's even able to pretty much, you know, send these guys flying and slam them around with his attacks. These guys are definitely, Elder Dragon status and are Elder Dragons. He's even been able to overpower Elder Dragon-like beings. Characters like Devil Joe and, that almost fell. Sorry. Characters like Devil Joe. Actually killed Shera Ishvalda with a simple hit to the head. This actually cracked Shera Ishvalda's skull, and it was incredible. Very impressive. Very impressive strength feat, I might add. He cracked Shera Ishvalda's skull and is incredibly durable, actually possessing regeneration down to his molecular level. Even being killed, or at least probably faking being killed by the hunter, even had a mountain. Collapsed on him, and he just got back up, went to kill Shera Ishvalda. He's also taken attacks from Teostra, Rajang, Devil Joe, Velkana, and Lunastra. Lunastra even brings out a supernova, which is actually confirmed to be comparable to a supernova, which is aka a living star, an exploding star with pretty much the force to annihilate anything, even planets. So I think it's safe to say that Nergigante is incredibly durable, also incredibly fast, being able to keep up with Morgan Ainslin, God Rathalos. He's also fought against God Rathalos to the point where the planet cracked open and the heavens even shook with the, you know, intensity of their battle. Nergigante is just powerful across the board. He possesses his regeneration, and he's really durable, even durable against soul manipulation attacks from characters like Morgan Ainslin and Wesker. So yeah, I think it's safe to say that, Nergigante is incredibly, incredibly powerful altogether. But in the other corner, Fin Fang Foom. This was basically Marvel's idea of Godzilla gone horribly wrong. Fin Fang Foom is an elder or an old dragon or whatever, an ancient dragon that has been long since, you know, renowned throughout the Marvel Universe as one of its signature characters. Fin Fang Foom is incredibly strong. Actually, he's able to battle against both Hulk and Thor. Was able to knock out Iron Man and the Amadeus Cho version of the Hulk. He's able to level cities and rip apart the planet's tectonic plates with just by burrowing through them. He's also been able to take out Terax, a Herald of Galactus. But who really hasn't taken out Terax lately? He just sucks across the board. But anyway, that's besides the point. Fin Fang Foom is also incredibly durable. Actually being able to regenerate just from just a pile of blood, which was pretty gross, but pretty cool at the same time. He's taken attacks from Iron Man, Thor, and Hulk, and has gotten back up pretty easily, even taking a combined assault from the Fantastic Four. Reed Richards even brought a gun specialized to take down Fin Fang Foom, and it did not do its job, or at least complete the task, because Fin Fang Foom was hurt by it, but he got back up like, bruh, why'd you shoot me with that? Excuse me while I take this sip real quick. vitamin water today, guys. Had some vitamin water. So where was I? Right. So Fin Fang Foom also possesses a couple abilities like, almost forgot speed. He's incredibly fast, able to react in microseconds, being able to, tag Iron Man and actually move as a blur, being able to tag Thor, even Heralds of Galactus, you know. Terrax is still faster than light, I guess, to immeasurable speeds. Probably wouldn't put him there because he's kind of one of the worst Heralds of Galactus, in my opinion. I mean, he just really sucks, but he's still a Herald of Galactus, nevertheless, so respect is respect, whatever it is. So, yeah. So, honestly, I could say Fin Fang Foom is incredibly strong and fat, durable and fast. Yost is a mist breath, being capable of burning the Hulk's skin, being able to harm Thor and Iron Man, who should be, you know, relatively, sorry, this was Iron Man, classic armor. Classic armor, Iron Man is able to take a blast from characters like Silver Surfer. So I think it's safe to say this Mystic Breath is capable of at least tossing around or at least destroying a moon at the very least. Probably not a whole full, you know, a big planet, but definitely at least small planet range, I'll have to say. So, yeah, he also possesses shape-shifting, mind control. Also being able to, transmutate objects. So, yeah, that's Fin Fang Foom for you guys. So, let us begin. Today we have Nergigante's semifinals. So, can he take down Fin Fang Foom? Well, let's find out. And first things first, size equalize. We're going to have this a bit more of a fair match here. I don't want Nergigante to have an unfair speed advantage or an unfair size advantage. And Fin Fang Foom has an unfair size advantage as well. So Fin Fang Foom can get himself to about 300 feet. So we use that max height. So we have a 300-foot Fin Fang Foom versus a 300-foot Nergigante. So let's begin. So first things first, physicality. Now, in my opinion, Nergigante is stronger than Fin Fang Foom. Yeah, you could say, but he's giving Hulk, Thor, and the Cho version of the Hulk trouble. Yeah, but still, I would cement myself and cement my, you know, my opinion as him being the stronger one out of the two. Because honestly, Amadeus Cho version of the Hulk has never struck me as impressive. I mean, he barely even beat a clone of the Hulk. That's not really something you want to show, okay? Then the fact that Fin Fang Foom only makes these guys struggle. Sorry, makes Hulk and Thor struggle. And really doesn't, you know, beat these guys. Isn't really a good look here. So yeah, I have to say that Fin Fang Foom is, you know, the weaker one out of the two. Durability, they're actually pretty equal here. I will say Nergigante has a faster regeneration process, though. He can just simply regenerate just on the spot. Horns, limbs, organs, all that good stuff. Boom. He can even regrow a new body if his current one is killed. He can just regrow a new body. Not sure how, though, but that does prove Nergigante is effectively immortal and unkillable. So, we have speed. Now, Nergigante's speed is comparable to Morgan. And Fin Fang Foom's speed is roughly comparable to Iron Man. So, in my opinion, who's faster? Well, in my opinion, that's Morgan. Classic days, Iron Man was barely faster than the speed of sound. Wasn't even the fastest character there. He was at least around Mach 4. Yeah. Morgan is able to move at the speed of a shadow, which, as I had to look up, is exactly 8.2 nanoseconds. Nergigante is able to keep up with Morgan in combat. It's even given a full description of how he and Morgan fight. It was a literal aerial battle. So honestly, Nergigante is faster here. So at the end of the day here, who do I think wins? Well, greater strength. Greater speed, better healing factor, and can use spikes, and is a better fighter than Fin Fang Foom. Nergigante takes this match. Honestly, I expected it. Yeah. Fin Fang Foom is kind of the insult to monsters, okay? This guy comes around, you think he's gonna start off good. They're gonna make a rival to Godzilla. But then next thing you know, he's jobbing to everybody. Captain Marvel knocked him out. Amadeus Cho, version of the Hulk, the weakest version of the Hulk, knocked him out. I mean, really, what's going on here? Like, is this the monster you guys tried to create? The monster y'all said would give Godzilla a challenge? Nah, it's really a joke. It's honestly, it is what it is here. You could say Fin Fang Foom could at least give Nergigante a good fight with him being able to, well, at least give Hulk and Thor some trouble, even being called a challenge. But that's the best you can say. You can't say Fin Fang Foom, you know, beats these guys. You can't say Fin Fang Foom, beats Nergigante either. I mean, at the end of the day here, Nergigante is also more aggressive than Fin Fang Foom. Now, you could say, what about the transmutation or the telepathy? Okay, well, let's dive into that a little bit. It's not going to work at all. I mean, really, Nergigante mindset, I don't even think would allow him to be controlled here. I don't even think Nergigante would even be controlled by Fin Fang Foom at all. This is a guy who ignores an Elder Dragon's presence, who actually goes towards other Elder Dragons, who actually ignores White Fatalis, a powerful dragon that also uses telepathy. Okay? That's how powerful Nergigante is. He'll just throw you out. And honestly, Fin Fang Foom's telepathy is really not on the level of some other Marvel characters, like Emma Frost, Professor X, Thanos, Moondragon, just to name a few. Even the weaker telepaths are probably more powerful than Fin Fang Foom. Fin Fang Foom. Blah. Sorry about that. And then you have the transmutation. How's that going to work against his regeneration, which extends down to molecular level? That means he's durable down to the molecular level. If you can't really just get rid of a limb, can't take off a limb, or at least permanently do it, yeah, you're not, it doesn't look too good here for you guys. I mean, honestly, it's just, it doesn't look good for Fin Fang Foom. Even when size is equalized, it actually looks worse for Fin Fang Foom. Because now you have an opponent that's going to keep your pin down, beat the living snot out of you, and you really, there's rarely anything you could do about it. Even if you try to retreat, Nergigante could just snatch him by his tail and say, nah, you ain't doing that, get back here, please. Boom, bam, pow. Hit him with the Hulk versus Loki combo and be done with it, okay? That's Nergigante's, this is this battle in a nutshell. I mean, this guy was even struggling with Cyclops, Wolverine, and Emma Frost. I think that's a decent team. I think it's pretty powerful. But it's not a full X-Men roster, you guys. So, at the end of the day here, yeah, Nergigante wins. So, please comment down below, like, and subscribe, and share with your friends. This is Legendary Ghidorah, and I will see you guys later. Peace.